Good evening to you. We continue to track the motion of these thunderstorms moving east, and the storm that's come into now northern Shawnee County, taking a look at that. It is now just to the northeast of downtown Topeka. Have had new reports of golf ball size hail. We did get a confirmation of the golf ball size hail at Silver Lake, also in North Topeka at Rochester Road and 24, also in 2200 Northwest Tyler. So again, North Topeka area has been hit pretty hard with some golf ball size hail out of the storm. It's moving to Grantville, may pass a little north of Tecumseh, and then continue to move on into southwestern Jefferson County toward Perry State Park, as we were tracking it in that direction earlier. Ozaukee will get the rain out of this, as will areas right along I-70, but it looks like the core of the hail is actually rather small. The warning has just expired. It will be extended on over to the east from there. There's a continual, area of showers and thunderstorms over Linden, all the way up into now northwestern portion of Franklin County. This is not severe, but it is producing some heavy rain. And again, I want to point out the severe thunderstorm warning for northern Shawnee County was expired. It has been extended over into Jefferson County for that potential for that hail up to golf ball size hail. So again, that's what we're looking at on the severe thunderstorm threat. Future track shows by 2:15, still some showers and thunderstorms around. We'll track another area of thunderstorms in tomorrow morning. That'll sweep across the area through the morning hours. This is along and just ahead of our approaching cold front. By the time it gets into the eastern counties, we may once again be conducive for some hail and high winds out of that. So that is your threat through about midday, early afternoon tomorrow. And then the front will be pushed east and will be cooling down. Right now, 67 degrees and calm, picked up nearly an inch of rain from this activity in Topeka, with more added to it now. Very little to the south. Some of this rain was overnight last night, over 1 3/4 of an inch of rain at Fort Riley, and 3/4 to an inch between Topeka and Lawrence, 2.5 inches at Kansas City. And again, that's so far since midnight. 67 at Manhattan, 68 for Emporia, 70 in Burlington right now. Should hold into the upper 60s tomorrow morning for much of the area, and warm perhaps into the low 70s. But notice by 4 o'clock, temperatures are falling behind the front. Breezy weather moves in, and upper 40s and breezy for Friday morning. Hard to get out of the 50s to low 60s with the windy conditions on Friday, and then some upper 30s around by Saturday morning. Definitely chilly weather coming our way. 66 with more storms late tonight and into the morning. By tomorrow, low 70s is the best we can manage, with a 70% chance of scattered storms. Windy and quite a bit cooler. 63 may be optimistic that we'll hit that on Friday. 37 Saturday morning, high of 65 on Saturday, mid 70s for Sunday and Monday. Let's look at some of the storms, of wall cloud west of Manhattan from earlier this evening from Aaron Harries. Also a look at some of the storms near Alma. Beautiful view there from Lucia Hasselhorst right at the sunset. Lightning striking near Holton with one of those intense storms earlier from Dylan Kaloran, and some of the skies of those storms building up at Manhattan from Deb Scott. Now we've got one lone severe thunderstorm still moving through now into southern Jefferson County with up to golf ball size hail with that storm as it's exiting out of Grantville and into Jefferson County.
So not out of the woods yet for the evening?
Not quite. We're getting closer to being done with them.
All right. Thanks, Matt.